1937, there were 30.8 motor vehicle-related deaths per 100,000 people in the United States. By 2019, that number decreased to 11.9 per 100,000. But what if it could be zero? Volvo's Safety Center, opened in 2000 in Gothenburg, Sweden, believes it has the tools to reach that goal. The $81 million state-of-the-art facility is host to an average of 2 crash tests every day and includes a pivoting, rotating crash track, a crane that drops vehicles from 98 feet in the air, and an outdoor space for rollover and runoff accident simulations. Since its inception in 1927, Volvo has been synonymous with safety. It was a Volvo engineer, Niels Bohlin, who in 1959 introduced the first 3-point safety belt, an invention that the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration estimates saved 329,715 lives between 1960 and 2012. Volvo also introduced the first rear-facing child safety seat in 1972, and in 1994, it introduced the world's first side-impact airbags.
Volvo has a reputation for safety, and you know, in my experience, I think it's well-deserved. You know, Volvo is independently working to identify problems, you know, safety problems that need to be addressed, coming up with solutions, and then keeping those solutions in their design process.
The Safety Center has 2 primary test tracks. One is 354 feet long, and the other 505 feet long. The shorter track is movable and can be set at any angle between 0 and 90 degrees to allow for multi-car tests and tests at varying speeds and angles.
We can reconstruct more or less any type of crash situation here in this lab. So what we can do here is that we can recreate a front-to-front crash, a side crash, or as we have done and talked about, also a runoff road type of crash could be generated in this environment.
Runoff road crash tests are performed outside and simulate an accident where the vehicle leaves the road and is briefly airborne before colliding with a ditch. These tests are performed in conjunction with the RoboCoaster, a robot that can be programmed to simulate what happens to an occupant in a runoff road crash. Rollover crashes are also performed outside using a hydraulic platform that launches a vehicle into a rollover motion at different heights and speeds. One of the more shocking tests done at the Safety Center is the crane drop, in which a vehicle plummets towards the ground from a height of 98 feet. The test is performed so that emergency responders can practice rescues from high-impact crashes with the jaws of life. In order to accurately represent real people, Volvo has a large variety of crash dummies to replicate different sizes of men, women, and small children. Each test dummy is equipped with sensors that notify researchers which parts of a passenger's body would be safest and which would be the most vulnerable in a crash. Both the car and barriers are fitted with sensors that record the entire chain of events in detail.
And we create a situation with accelerometers, sensing motion pattern and forces in the car. We have extensive footage, and that is done by adding extra capabilities, light capabilities. We can run cameras with around 1,000 frames per second to really understand the details of the crash. And then we run it in this crash facility, and we could generate the same type of crash that we have seen out in field crashes.
Field crashes that are studied by the Volvo accident research team.
They have the task of understanding what goes on in traffic. You know, because if you start with what technology is available, you are limited to what's out there. They will travel to accidents within a reasonable driving distance from Gothenburg. Reason for that is because, you know, we want to know the time of day. We want to know the road conditions, and these things can shift.
If we have a accident collision with injuries involved, we will ask the permission from the user or driver of the car to get a medical journal from the hospital. And then with this knowledge, we can go further down and do in-depth studies of crash situations that we find important for our customers. How did this injury pattern occur? Why did this occur? And how could we change the event?
What may be possible is that people don't get seriously injured or killed, and that, you know, may come about by a combination of providing better protection to people when crashes occur, as well as you know, outfitting cars with systems that help drivers avoid crashing, or at least mitigate the conditions of the crash that would have occurred otherwise.
Our ultimate goal is zero. People are excellent drivers when they're at their best. And then you have life. Life can be hard. So focus for us is not so much the why, but more the what can we do for you? How can we help you be the best driver you can possibly be in whatever situation you're in? There's a beginning to safety development, but there is no end, because it is a circle. It goes on.